Mr. Dhananjay, okay, Mr. Jayaprakash Hegde, of India want to see punishment. These people punished. They've taken the people of this country and the people of their state for granted. How will they be punished?
Arnab, we cannot pass a judgment here.
Why?
Since the Honorable Speaker has permitted the
Why?
Tour of these MLAs.
The Honorable Speaker,
in his wisdom, will have to
the
take
The Honorable
decision.
Speaker of Karnataka
cannot,
with...
Cannot,
1 minute.
Pass a judgment
the,
on this.
Does the Honorable Speaker of Karnataka know that they went to see a tango dance? Does he know they went to Machu Picchu? Does he know that they went to a crocodile park? Does he know that they have been spending time at the Copacabana Beach Resort? Does he know that there is no government work that is to be done there? And are you telling me, Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, that if the Speaker has cleared it, then anything happens, anything is allowed, the Speaker cannot be questioned, or if fresh facts are presented, then the Speaker's decision itself cannot be subject to verification? Why are you shooting off the Speaker's shoulder?
All this can be... all this can be discussed on the floor of the House.
What discussed on the floor of the House?
And its wisdom can take a decision.
One minute. These people have gone on study trips. They have lied. They say we have gone to study. What are they studying?
This cannot be discussed outside the purview of the legislature.
Why?
This will have to be discussed within the...
Now you are avoiding the question. Now you... Why can't you discuss? Why can't you discuss?
The punishment aspect of it is concerned.
Why can't you discuss?
You have been arguing that they should be punished.
It is taxpayer money. They are going from Bangalore to Dubai, Dubai to Buenos Aires, Buenos Aires to Lima, Lima to Peru, Peru to Brazil, Brazil to Sao Paulo, Sao Paulo to Rio de Janeiro, Rio de Janeiro to Dubai, Dubai to Bangalore. I mean, this is an incredible holiday they have given themselves. And I want an answer from you tonight, Mr. Dhananjay Kumar. Why you are shooting off the Speaker's shoulder?
I'm only trying to give you a little caution that probably we are defaming the decision of the legislature
Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, your attempts to Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, your Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, your attempts to
better it should be left to the wisdom of
Mr. Dhananjay Kumar.
Let there be discussion.
Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, your transparent attempt to intimidate me on national television has been observed, but I am unaffected by it. Because if the Speaker did not know that they were going for a tango dance for an eco park, is it not appropriate that the people of the state will ask? That just because they've got the Speaker's permission, can nobody ask them questions for it? And I'm not defaming the Speaker. I'm saying fresh facts are being brought to the Speaker's knowledge. Now, what political decision will you take against these drought junket MLAs?
Arnab, that will have to be decided by the people. People get an opportunity to decide.
So we will not do anything. You are saying we will not do anything against these MPs, MLAs.
We have condemned it. BJP has condemned it. Even the Congress has condemned it, and they have said that we are recording
condemned
the members.
Condemned it.
Yeah, we have condemned.
Ramji Chandran, the Mr. Dhananjay Kumar says we've condemned it. That's it. He's making it clear to people of Karnataka tonight the BJP will do nothing more than that.
I don't understand. Is there, if for example, the question I have to ask is, has the Speaker actually sanctioned money for all the legislators to go on a holiday? Then if it's a study tour, and if we find out, if there's evidence that it is not a study tour, does the law not provide for any place where the legislators are misleading legislature? What is the penalty for people actually misleading the legislature, if indeed they have?
Mr. Subramaniam, you can answer that question. What punishment is there if there is a case of misleading and misrepresentation? Asks Ramji Chandran from Bangalore tonight. And I can tell you, Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, if you keep your finger on the pulse of the people of Bangalore tonight, they are not going to let this matter go away so easily. Yes, Mr. Subramaniam.
If it is a study tour, I would like to see the itinerary, the schedule, who they met, what are the study made, what are the report, what are the observations, what are the meetings that they had with the various experts on the various subjects there. In the absence of all that, it will be not inappropriate to conclude that it was not a study tour. The first thing would be ask them to return all the expenses, number one. Ask them to apologize in public, saying that they misrepresented and went went for a holiday at public expense, and please say, I am sorry. I think this would be adequate punishment. Real punishment should be given to those people who conceived of this plan and gave them the opportunity, and the persons who took the decision that every MLA will go there. Why only Karnataka? Why not all over India? Why only MLAs? Why not all block adhyakshas, block pramukhs? Don't they all have to be educated? Don't they all have to know? There are hell of a lot of public servants. Why shouldn't everybody go for
Mr.
holiday
Kumar,
everywhere?
Mr. Dhananjay,
why only Karnataka MLAs?
And this attempt to shoot the messenger, you see, will not work. Your attempts to intimidate the media, we will pass some legislative orders against you indirectly, which you are trying to say tonight, will not work. We are asking you the question. I'm asking you the question again. By the way, they have also gone to see some waterfalls in different places. Very interesting tour. They're doing a lot of study. Perhaps they are gone there to study class 6 geography all over again. My question is to Jayaprakash Hegde. Jayaprakash Hegde, will the Congress party be bold enough to punish its MLAs who have done this?
Our president, KPCC president, has already given a statement saying he is going to take action against the MLAs, those who have gone on tour.
He's going to take
definitely
action.
I think yesterday it has appeared in the newspaper also.
So why can't you, Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, Congress party, you heard them right now, what's holding you back?
I have told you, Arnab, that we have already condemned, and our leader Mr. Yediyurappa has asked the Chief Minister, the Speaker, to recall all those MLAs who have gone on such a kind of tour. After they are coming back, probably the legislature in its wisdom will take a decision. That is what I have been submitting. You cannot pass a judgment without giving them an opportunity. As Mr. Subramaniam has rightly pointed out, let them submit a report. What is the kind of study they have made? And how they have improved their information or knowledge?
Thank you. Absolutely.
Then only we can pass.
But
during the visit, a little bit of entertainment is possible.
Mr. Dhananjay Kumar,
we need not blow it out of proportion.
That's the problem. You see, whenever any facts are presented, you always say we are blowing it out of proportion. Now, we have seen today an all-party consensus.
No, I don't say that.
No, you say
that.
But Mr. Dhananjay Kumar,
please
ask those people tonight.
Yeah.
I would suggest, please call them, contact them, ask your Chief Minister to call them and say that today it is the third, or today is the 2nd of September 2012. It is better if you take the next flight back home.
Maybe they should. That's what I have been telling you.
Then let them come back.
We have condemned and we have asked them to come back.
And if they don't come back, let the country know that despite the expose, these MLAs are unwilling to come back. They want to complete their study tour. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining me on the News Hour tonight. Thank you.